I'm Kelsey Brennan-Wessels for ESA Web TV, and I'm here today with Kristof, who is the Sentinel-3 Engineering and AIV Manager. And we're standing in front of the Sentinel-3B satellite. So my first question is, what does AIV mean?
It's assembly, integration, testing, and verification.
So what are you responsible for?
Well, together with my team of skilled engineers, we're following up from concept, design concept of the satellite, up to building the satellite, integrating the satellite, testing the satellite, verifying that everything is fine. Before we then ship it to the launch site, we will launch it from there. And then once the satellite is launched, we will follow from the results that come from space and analyze the data and make sure the satellite is properly functioning. So this is all the activities that, together with my engineering team, we're following up.
And what are the major challenges in building a satellite like Sentinel-3B?
The major engineering challenges, let me give an example. Everybody at home, when you do redecoration or something, you use a measuring ruler. You try to measure something accurately, you know it's not always easy to measure accurately. Or for example, when you want to take pictures of your kids running around in the garden, you know it's very difficult to have a very sharp, good, steady picture. Now you have to imagine, I put you on a platform, and we're going to put this platform to do the same tasks, but at an altitude of about 815 kilometers. And then I'm going to ask, okay, can you now take pictures of the Earth very accurately? Can you measure the sea surface, for example, with an accuracy of a few millimeters? Can you measure the temperature of the sea and of the land with an accuracy of 0.3 degrees? You still have to imagine that this platform on which you're standing is in the meantime moving at 7 kilometers per second. So on top of that, I will also ask you to take these pictures not only once and do these temperature and altitude measurements not only once, but do it 24 hours per day continuously for 1 year, 6 years, 7 years, 10 years, 30 years. And this is the engineering challenge you see here. So it means that you need very good instruments with the newest technologies. And you also need a very good performance stable platform. And that's what all the engineers, thanks to teamwork with industry, it's an example of European cooperation, have been able to build.
And of course, you're not just doing this with one instrument, you're doing it with multiple instruments. Yes. On the Sentinel satellite.
Exactly.
Now, I understand that when building the Sentinel-3A satellite, this satellite was also being built in parallel. Why is that?
We procured the satellites in parallel because it gives advantages. It means that it's easier to develop things. You can immediately order several equipments at the same time. And for example, when the Sentinel-3A was in this state, completely finished, the Sentinel-3B satellite was already completely finished, the bottom part, but the main payloads were not yet integrated. They were still in development. Now, what advantages gives that is that, for example, you're building the satellite and say during the last integration phases you discover a problem with an equipment or something gets damaged or you find a damage to an equipment, it can happen. Then, of course, this gives you flexibility because you have exactly the same copy available on the other satellite you're building or which is standing in the clean room next to you. So this allows you to quickly exchange or investigate first on that equipment what could be wrong, and then once you know the problem, solve the problem and retrofit it on the satellite you want to fly as soon as possible. Also, the advantage of having two things in parallel being built is that you can compare measuring results. So test results. You can immediately compare whether they make sense if you compare from one satellite to the other. For example, now with Sentinel-3B, this one is now standing here in the clean room while Sentinel-3A is flying in orbit.
And Sentinel-3C, is it somewhere around here?
Is already somewhere around. It's not yet here in this clean room, but at this moment the equipments have all been procured, they've all been delivered, and we are ready to start the integration of the Sentinel-3C at the moment. So also there, in case we would need to retrofit or support or replace an equipment, we can always exchange it with the other satellites that are being built. And then, for example, when we now want to come to test in system tests, performance measurements, then we also have now the Sentinel-3A in orbit, from which we learned a lot the past 2 years, and then we can implement these things into the activities we're currently performing.
Okay, well, Kristof, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you.
And to our viewers, to learn more about space or about our planet or about Sentinel-3, you can visit our website, www.esa.int.